By and by the black clouds rolled away and showed a blue sky overhead, with the silver moon shining sweetly in the middle of it and little stars winking merrily at Dorothy when she looked their way. The coop did not toss around any more and rode the waves more gently, almost like a cradle rocking, so that the floor upon which Dorothy stood was no longer swept by water coming through the slats. Seeing this, and being quite exhausted by the excitement of the past few hours, the little girl decided that sleep would be the best thing to restore her strength, and the easiest way in which she could pass the time. The floor was damp, and she was herself wringing wet, but fortunately this was a warm climate, and she did not feel at all cold. So she sat down in a corner of the coop, leaned her back against the slats, nodded at the friendly stars before she closed her eyes, and was asleep in half a minute. End of chapter 1. The Yellow Hen. A strange noise awoke Dorothy, who opened her eyes to find that day had dawned, and the sun was shining brightly in a clear sky. She had been dreaming that she was back in Kansas again, and playing in the old barnyard with the calves and pigs and chickens all around her, and at first, as she rubbed the sleep from her eyes, she really imagined she was there. Ah, here again was the strange noise that had awakened her. Surely it was a hen cackling. But her wide-open eyes first saw through the slats of the coop the blue waves of the ocean, now calm and placid, and her thoughts flew back to the past night, so full of danger and discomfort. Also she began to remember that she was a waif of the storm, adrift upon a treacherous and unknown sea.
Buck, 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 buck.
"What's that?" cried Dorothy, starting to her feet.
"Why, I've just laid an egg, that's all,"
replied a small but sharp and distinct voice. And looking around her, the little girl discovered a yellow hen squatting in the opposite corner of the coop. "Dear me!" she exclaimed in surprise. "Have you been here all night, too?"
"Of course,"
answered the hen, fluttering her wings and yawning.
"When the coop blew away from the ship, I clung fast to this corner with claws and beak, for I knew if I fell into the water I'd surely be drowned. Indeed, I nearly drowned as it was. With all that water washing over me, I never was so wet before in my life."
"Yes," agreed Dorothy, "it was pretty wet for a time, I know. But do you feel comfortable now?"
"Not very. The sun has helped dry my feathers, as it has your dress, and I feel better since I laid my morning egg. But what's to become of us, I should like to know, afloat on this big pond?"
"I'd like to know that, too," said Dorothy. "But tell me, how does it happen that you are able to talk? I thought hens could only cluck and cackle."
"Why, as for that," answered the yellow hen thoughtfully, "I've clucked and cackled all my life, and never spoken a word before this morning that I can remember. But when you asked a question a minute ago, it seemed the most natural thing in the world to answer you. So I spoke, and I seem to keep on speaking just as you and other human beings do. Strange, isn't it?"